A former politician has been accused of betraying the country after being targeted by foreign intelligence agencies. Let's bring in Nine Federal Politics reporter now, Claudia Vedroljak. Claudia, sensitive information has been handed over.
That's right, Sarah, but ASIO wouldn't go as far as revealing who that ex-politician is nor the country behind the A-team. What Chief Spy Mike Burgess would say, though, is the foreign spies tried to target a former Australian Prime Minister by enlisting the politician who at one stage proposed bringing a family member of the PM into the spies' orbit. Now, that never happened, but national security and defence priorities were passed on to the group by an academic who was sent on an all-expenses-paid trip to an overseas conference. ASIO has dismantled the group, we understand, was operating until late last year. Today, analysts and Australia's top spy are warning it's not just people in power being targeted and that all Australians need to be aware.
Every country does it, but some countries do it more aggressively than others. Clearly, in this region, we're facing a rising major power with China that is very aggressive in its use of intelligence gathering. And I think that everyone needs to be conscious of the risks of engaging with foreign nationals in this sort of thing.
Burgess has also warned the threat from racist, violent extremism persists, saying there's the possibility of a terrorist attack or attack planning in the next 12 months. Sarah also confirming ASIO is currently investigating multiple individuals who have discussed conducting terrorism in Australia.
The ASIO boss also warned about a spy network that he dubbed the A-team recruiting an ex-politician. So who sold out our story? Any clues there?
Look, the ASIO boss quite correctly didn't give away details. I think most people would work out the likely country behind this. They are a major world power that is determined to dominate the region. And espionage and intelligence gathering operations as part of their modus vivendi. So they are active here on Australian soil trying to recruit Australian citizens, and clearly they almost had some sort of success with this politician, which will go unnamed.
So the idea that the politicians can orbit in the circles of spies isn't a new one. It's been going on for eons. But it is shocking from a national security point of view. I don't know why you wouldn't name someone who has done that kind of activity that could be treason, sedition?
You wouldn't name it for legal reasons, simple as that. But I think that, yeah, intelligence gathering, spying is the world's second oldest profession. Every country does it, but some countries do it more aggressively than others. Clearly, in this region, we're facing a rising major power with China that is very aggressive in its use of intelligence gathering. And I think that everyone needs to be conscious of the risks of engaging with foreign nationals in this sort of thing.
All right, Malcolm, good on you. What's the oldest profession, by the way? Journalism?
Well, I think we understand what that one is.
Yes, I think we do.
Some of us better than others. Good on you, mate. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Look, the deeper we go, the more we become a target. Our top spy warning overnight, terror attacks are a real threat here at home and couldn't be more serious.
I think that's right. And I mean, there's a few points here as well. I mean, Mike Burgess pointed both to the threat of terrorism and I think, an increased temperature, if I could put it that way, since October 7. And it's a bit of a reminder, I feel, for all of us to be doing what we can to be promoting social cohesion, to try to bring the temperature down in Australia. And that's not denying anyone's right to have their freedom of expression about what's happening in the Middle East. But we do need to be thinking about our own social cohesion and our own way of life here in Australia. Of course, the other thing that he spoke about was state actors, foreign espionage here in Australia. And that is a really big threat too. And those of us who are involved in public administration, politicians, but not just politicians, people in senior public servants, those engaged in a number of our critical agencies, we've got to be really focused about those who seek to influence what we do, and that what we do is always based solely on Australia's national interest.
I guess, I mean, I found it pretty staggering last night. He said last night the threat is realer now, and it doesn't help when former politicians or aspiring politicians are betraying Australia. That was a pretty startling revelation. I mean, who was it, and are we pursuing it in any way, shape or form?
Well, obviously, ASIO is all over this, which is why he's described this situation. I am not aware of the specific facts which underpin the scenario that Mike Burgess has outlined. And, you know, and I respect the reasons why that is important to be kept confidential. But I think it is also really important that this story be put out in the public domain, which is what Mike Burgess has done, because, you know, those of us engaged in public life, but not just us, but certainly us, need to be really vigilant about the fact that there will be those who seek to influence what we do, and our job, our calling, is about Australia's national interest. That has to be focused. And I think the way in which Mike Burgess put it last night, that the person involved sold out both their colleagues, their party, but also the nation, is spot on.
Well, treason and sedition come to mind, don't they? The most serious of accusations. We've run out of time. We appreciate your time, Richard. Thank you.
And again, the top boss spoke about a spy network dubbed the A-Team, which recruited an ex-politician who sold out the country. So who's the politician?
I have been thinking about that. Do I know them? But I do think it's... Firstly, congratulations to Mike Burgess and ASIO for bringing down the A-Team, but it is a glimpse of the sophistication with which they are all operating now, and we are all clearly going to have to be far more vigilant because this thing is operating on perhaps far more frequently than maybe we were thinking about on a day-to-day basis.
It's in our interest to know who it was, though, right? I mean, we need to be able to trust our politicians, and this completely undermines all of that, Annika.
Well, I imagine, and I'm imagining here, that there are probably legal issues at work that are precluding that, but I'll leave that for Mike Burgess to explain. Certainly, as a politician myself, the first thing I did was think about any recent conversations. And I think I can just say to you, Sarah, I think I have not been approached by any bad spies, because I haven't had any conversations
with
that person. Well, if they're a good spy, surely I wouldn't be suspicious, right? But if it was a bad spy, I would have thought, these
good
are strange
questions
to be
operating.
Good or
bad is in the eye of the beholder, though, it has to be said. I mean, Pete, seriously, this is a bit of an issue when you're hearing about politicians who potentially revealing Australian secrets here. We need to know who they are. We need to know who we can trust. We need to know how this is manifested.
What, Australian politicians not being truthful with us? That's not... surely not, Sarah. Surely not. Minister, come on. You know who it is. I can see straight through you. You know who it is. Come on.
I genuinely do not. And I just want to reassure you that with respect to our, you know, our national intelligence, I am a vault. They will not get me.
Pete, do you think we should be worried?
Oh, look, if they're saying that we should be worried, certainly. I mean, obviously, spies. I mean, when I first read that story, I felt like it was a Hollywood script. But, I mean, yeah, sure. But, look, as the Minister said, we're in good hands, obviously. But, yeah, you first read it, it just doesn't make sense. You think, hang on, we're in Australia. But, you know, it happens everywhere.